You wanted to see me, Teddy?
Absolutely, player. I've got some big news for you. Have a seat.
No thanks. I'd rather stand.
Suit yourself, dog. Now, I ain't gonna beat around the bush here. I'm just gonna come right out with it. You've just been traded to Raw.
What? What do you mean I've been traded?
Easy, easy. They really wanted you over there, player. You're exactly what they need to take Raw to the next level. And look, I'm not happy about losing a superstar of your caliber, but they made me an offer I just couldn't refuse. Believe that. They gave me everything except TV time on Monday nights to get your contract.
Well, I guess it's not hard to see why. That WWE title would look great around my waist.
See? That's what I'm talking about. So thanks for everything you've done for SmackDown, player. And good luck to you on Monday Night Raw.
Good luck to me? Hey, no hard feelings. But you're the one who just traded away the best superstar on your brand. Let me wish you luck. Because now that I'm a Raw superstar, SmackDown's gonna need it. Later, Teddy.
Champ, I just wanted to call and tell you that tonight, I'm going to give you just a small taste of exactly what I've got in store for you at Backlash. Now that I'm the number one contender, I guarantee that the WWE title is coming home with me. And there's not a damn thing you or anyone else can do about it.
You think you know me?
Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of my broadcast partner, Jerry the King Lawler and myself, welcome to Monday Night Raw. The King, I have to ask, have you ever seen Edge as focused as he has been the past few weeks?
Absolutely not, JR. I've never seen a superstar rise through the ranks as fast or as ruthlessly as Edge. And ever since Mr. McMahon personally named him the number one contender, he's been like a man possessed.
Possessed by an insatiable desire to hold the WWE title, that is. And I think that tonight, Edge is going to show the WWE champion exactly what he's got to look forward to at Backlash. And it won't be pretty. Respect in the world for Edge's experience and in-ring ability. But if I had to choose a superstar to represent Raw as our WWE champion, I've got to say that my choice would be this man right here.
Enjoy it while it lasts, JR, because I have a funny feeling that that title's going to be back around the waist of Edge come Backlash.
I wouldn't bet my Oklahoma farm on that, King. Let's see how the two of them match up here tonight in this non-title match before we start making any predictions.
Survive if I let you.
Welcome to Raw, live tonight from Fort Lauderdale, Florida. I'm Jim Ross, here with Jerry the King Lawler.
I love Fort Lauderdale, JR, especially around spring break.
Yahoo! Well, spring break only comes once a year, but Raw brings the excitement with it wherever we go, and tonight is no exception.
I tell you, King, sometimes I get exhausted just watching these superstars compete.
I know what you mean, JR. I don't think most people appreciate what incredible athletes these WWE superstars really are.
You've got to have some excellent conditioning to be able to do what they do.
Well, that's the name of the game, JR. You gotta keep moving. No dog ever peed on a moving car.
Oh, that's a lovely image, King.
This capacity crowd is solid behind their superstar.
Look at this! Wow, can you be any more biased, JR? How about some fair and balanced commentary?
crowd tonight, and who can blame them? They're certainly not getting much from Edge.
That's not true, JR. I'm sure this arena is just full of Edge heads tonight. You might not hear them cheering, but that's probably because they're at home. Sure. Now the fans start chipping. Now that he's in the driver's seat. Oh, no. I don't like the looks of this.
He's got the fans behind him, King, and his opponent has better luck now. Well, you can't ever accuse the...
Oh, no. This is terrible. You can't let your opponent build this kind of momentum.
Well, all I can say is someone's been eating their vitamins and saying their prayers. And there he goes. The submission is locked in.
Gosh, he might make his opponent tap right here. This has gone beyond just being a match, JR. I think these superstars genuinely hate each other.
There's no love lost between these competitors, that's for sure. If looks could kill, somebody would be pushing up daisies right now.
And you've got to admit, that makes for a much more interesting match, JR.
It sure does. But I just hope these superstars can settle their differences in the ring and leave it at... Look at this! Look at this! You're talking about a
timer back when your shoulders on the mat is no place to be.
Excellent counter. What ring presence? A reversal. Can he capitalize on it?
I'm so happy that we have a superstar like him. For himself and... He's a great leader for young
fans. Oh, he's a real role model, all right. And a real humanitarian. A guy who would just as soon sell you out as look at you.
What are you talking about, JR? That's just a nasty rumor spread by people who wanted to be in Edge's league, but couldn't keep up with it.
Come on, King. You got Edge of your design. Are you seeing this? Oh, great. Talking about someone whose heart is as cold. These two superstars meet again for the WWE title.
Never can tell, JR. I think both of them learned a lot about each other in this match. Next time they get in the ring together, you can bet they're both going to have a few new tricks.
All right, listen up. You are looking at the new general manager of Raw.
I don't believe this. This has to be some kind of sick joke. Mr. McMahon named Triple H interim GM.
That's right. I've decided to sacrifice my in-ring career for a little while in order to give Raw the leadership and direction it needs. Now I know that decision's going to disappoint a lot of you, but it's what's right for business, and I always do what's right for business. For example, although Edge has been named the number one contender for the WWE title, his match last week against the champion left me feeling a little... meh. So suffice it to say, with all the talent in the back, I think Raw can do better than that. And Edge actually won't be going to Backlash to compete for the WWE title.
Well, if Edge is out, who's our number one contender then?
Over the next few weeks, I'm going to conduct an exhaustive search to find the most worthy contender, and that search starts tonight when the champion faces five top Raw contenders in a non-title, over-the-top rope battle royal.
Here we go, the six-man battle royal to determine the number one contender for the WWE title at Backlash. And here comes, well, an interesting choice for our number one contender match.
Boy, Triple H wasn't kidding when he promised us an exhaustive search. The closest this guy's gotten to the WWE title was standing behind the champion in the buffet line.
And here's another unique entry for a battle royal that's supposed to help determine the number one contender for the WWE title.
Well, that's Triple H for you. He's approaching this general manager position with a fresh perspective and giving every Raw superstar a chance to earn their spot.
Ooh, trouble.
No offense to these superstars, but I don't think they exactly fit my view of who I would consider to be current WWE title contenders. I'm starting to question our new general manager's intentions.
Oh, JR, why do you always have to be so cynical? I'm sure Triple H has got a very good reason for choosing the superstars he's chosen, though I can't quite see what it is exactly.
Come on now, this is just absurd. I know there isn't a bad superstar on the entire Raw roster, but these guys are obviously not quite ready for prime time.
Boy, I'll bet these guys are glad you're not the general manager, JR. They're getting the opportunity of a lifetime, and you're raining all over their parade.
That does it. Now I've seen everything. Triple H is obviously up to something here, but I'll be damned if I can figure out what it is.
Calm down, JR. I'm sure Triple H has a plan. He wouldn't be our new general manager if he didn't know what he was doing.
I'm sure Triple H knows exactly what he's doing. He is a stupid, but I have no earthly idea what he's trying to do here.
I got to release all the that has made up my past. So go let yourself dance, baby. Time to free yourself at last. Unshackle your life spirit. Fire with a from the
a superstar who truly deserves the opportunity to main event a pay-per-view. If I had to put money on anyone in this match, I'd have to put it on him.
Yeah, but don't underestimate his opponent. Every one of us eliminates the WWE champion.
That's true, King. And no matter who you are, 5-on-1 odds are 5-on-1 odds. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Raw. Coming to you live from Seattle, Washington.
I don't care how heavy it gets, JR. Nothing's going to dampen the spirits of these Seattle fans.
You're right about that, King. Especially not when we've got such a great show ahead of us. It's hard for me to watch Trevor Murdoch. And I'm not just talking.
Looks like his hopes of winning this one have been shattered, JR.
That's it. Is over for that particular superstar.
Up and over and out. Chavo's always talking about living up to his family traditions, JR. But if I were his family, I'd make sure that his invitation to the family reunion got lost in the mail.
If you can't appreciate Chavo's ability, that's your own problem, King. Personally, I think the Guerreros have every right to take pride in the way he represents their legendary fans.
Wow! Listen to these fans, JR!
You can fool some of the people all the time, and all the people some of the time, but there's no fooling the WWE fans at all. That's one fewer superstar in this match.
His opponent telegraphed that one. Uh-oh! Come on! You gotta stop this guy before he really gets going!
Too much momentum to be stopped now.
Daivari thinks that everyone hates him.
Is that?
Here's your winner, Frank.
This is your general manager, so listen up.
I've been getting a lot of crap from Edge about how he deserves to be in the WWE title picture. So to shut him up, I'm teaming the two of you up against Carlito, Kane, and Kurt Angle tonight. I want to evaluate those guys as potential contenders and give Edge one more chance to prove that he deserves a title opportunity. Yeah, it's a 3-on-2 match, but you're the WWE champion, so suck it up, champ.